वेल डियर स्टूडेंट्स, 10th ग्रुप जेसिस इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल विजयपुरा कर्नाटका, एंड आई एम योर इंग्लिश फैकल्टी इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू मिस शाश्वती चौधरी। ऑलरेडी फ्रॉम द स्कूल मैनेजमेंट कॉर्नर यू हैव गॉट द व्हाट्सएप मैसेज। आई माइसेल्फ अनाउंस्ड ऑल्सो, यू नो द लास्ट डे, सो टुमारो इज अ वेरी गुड डे। टुमारो वेडनेसडे 25th November 2020. So whatever pandemic coronavirus, we are fighting against it, taking full protection and all. You also do in the same manner, but your life, your future planning, it should not be destroyed. 200 rupees and other documents, please. You come to the school tomorrow and do all the formalities, complete all the formalities, because with 200 rupees general quota and 50 rupees SC/ST quota, you will get very nicely your Karnataka state government scholarship. So 200 rupees for your state Karnataka, it is not for school management or nothing. So keep it this matter clear the view, and come tomorrow sharp in the school premise, talk with headmaster, and then accordingly complete all the formalities. I would like to see not only I, our all full JC's team management, the class 10, you all are going to sit for this scholarship examination. First you sit, then you become successful automatically, but first you should have courage to sit. It is not too much money your state government has declared. It is very nominal charge, rupees 200 for the general and SC/ST rupees 50. So full class 10, you should come forward, boys and girls. I would like to see with my full team member that tomorrow whole class 10 you are coming, and in the school premise you will meet your headmaster, complete your formalities for the state Karnataka government scholarship examination. State Karnataka will give you scholarship, and this is a merit test, competition test. You all are very good students, so don't neglect this opportunity. So you should come tomorrow and face the difficulties, solve the problems, complete the formalities. So that full team 10th group, you should be able to get chance of a scholarship from your state Karnataka. Now already I have announced in my previous lesson, 10th group, today new poem, unit 4 poem, that is a new topic today we are going to start. Let me start now, The Song of India by V.K. Gokak. Before that, board work, please go through it. Today's topic, unit 4 poem, The Song of India by V.K. Gokak. And obviously, 10th group, today's day, 24/11/2020. Concept of this lesson, obviously, similar in manner to previous topic, you know. So, generally, the concept is in the same manner, national visionary. And learning points, you see, read the poem, listening to the poem, reading and appreciating, mark important lines. So let's start today's topic, unit 4 poem, class 10. Get ready with your all attachment, textbook, one pencil will be in your hand, and your notebook should be ready. 10th group, get ready. Page 81. The title of the poem is The Song of India, written and composed by V.K. Gokak. Before going to start the poem, 10th standard, you see, turn page number 84. Page 84, about the poet. About the poet. And who is the poet here? V.K. woke up. What is the title of the poem? The Song of India. India is our motherland. The Song of India. Page 84, 10th group. Listen carefully. Vinayaka Krishna Gokak, 1909 to 1992, was born at Savanan, Dharwad district, and was educated at Karnataka College and then at Oxford. He is a widely traveled man and he held several important educational posts. He received the Padma Shri Award and Sahitya Academy Award and Gyanpeeth Award. As a poet, he was one of the leading figures of the Navya Kavya's New Poetry movement of the 1950s in Kannada poetry. In this poem, the poet proclaims that the time has come to establish the new ideals, that is the new ideas, new thoughts, new opinions, new suggestions. Let's start the poem, The Song of India by V.K. Gokak. All the glossaries, word meanings you will get page wise down. So, wherever you will have doubt, you will read it immediately. What song shall I sing of you, my mother? I asked, I referred to the poet here. That one, V.K. Gokak, the poet. And here, mother referred to whom? My mother. Here, mother referred to Mother Earth, Mother India, our motherland. So, Mother India, we salute our Mother India. We salute our Mother Earth. Here, Mother India. The Song of India means Mother Earth, Mother India. What song shall I sing of you, my mother? What type of song in the morning you want to listen, my mother? I asked, shall I sing of the Himalayas with their snow-born peaks, of the three seas that wash your palm? Palm means this one, palm, P-A-L-M. Shall I sing of your clear dawn? Dawn means before morning, before sunshine. Before sunrise, that is called dawn. Clear dawn with its pure gold streaks, sun is coming out, gold streaks. Said the mother, imperturbable. Now the mother, India, silently, she remained silent and she is willing to give the answer, the reply. Calm, C-A-L-M, means silent, absolute silence, that is called calm and quiet, C-A-L-M, and Q-U-I-E-T, quiet. Sing of the beggar and the leaper that swan my streets, sing of the field and the dirt that foul my sylvan treats, retreats. So here, said the mother, imperturbable, come, sing of the beggar and the leaper. You sing, in this country, lots of beggars, they are poor, they are struggling, they are sufferers. Sing of the beggar and the leper, that word that swam my streets. Sing of the field and the dart that foul my sylvan retreats. So Mother India told that she is willing to know about the beggars, about the poor people, how much they are struggling, in which way they are sacrificing every day after a hard struggle to get some benefit. Next one. What song shall I sing of you, my mother? Again, I. poet. Again, the poet is asking, my mother, what song shall I sing of you, my mother? I asked, shall I sing of your rock-cut temples, epics into stone? Epics, you know, Ramayana, Mahabharata, these are all the epics, that is the old ancient historical topics. Shall I sing of your rock-cut temples, lots of temples with rock-cut designs, epics in stone, of your children that died to call you their own, the soldiers every moment they are sacrificing their life in India, they are going to die or they are dying and so on. So what do you want, mother? I will tell you story of those people, their very own. Next, page number 82. Of the seers and prophets that hewed the straight path, for the man that pilgrims alone, said the mother in indignant words that beat into my ears like gong that flew about me, a pitiful thing. So this is all about your the Song of India. Till this much today, you read the poem, learn it, and obviously try to understand also carefully so that you should not have any trouble. So page 81 and page 82, you will complete your learning scheme of the poem, The Song of India by V.K. Gokak. Today. All right, thank you very much, children. God bless you.